And therefore Allah repeats, إِنَّ مَعَ الْعُسْرِ يُسْرِ. And with that difficulty, the same one before is another level of peace. And I want you always, my dear brother, my dear sister, to have that optimism in your heart. To know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not forget you and will not overlook you. And although the Prophet ﷺ in Ta'if, he says, Ya Arhamar Rahimeen, he never once tarries or falls behind in his love for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And it motivates him to go further and further towards that which will lead him to Allah's happiness and contentment in this life and in the next life for us and him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The Prophet returns to Mecca and these verses continue to be revealed to him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And on a fateful night that we can't identify which one it is, it could be the 27th of Rajab or other than it, Jibreel descends to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And in one riwayah, the Prophet was in the house of Hani. And in another riwayah, the Prophet ﷺ was sleeping in the hijr of Ismail. And Jibreel summons the Prophet ﷺ and operates on him. Jibreel opens his chest and washes his heart with the water of Zamzam. And then the Prophet ﷺ is cleansed of anger and hatred and iman, and hikmah is added to his heart. And in this hadith of the Prophet ﷺ, which is narrated by Anas and others in the Sahih and Bukhari and others, you hear that the Prophet ﷺ understands that he was made ready for the journey. And I want you to take this as a lesson for you and I, that not everything you can just walk into it in life. That even for the Prophet ﷺ, to be able to be given al-Isra wal-Mi'raj, something dramatic had to happen to him. Some cleansing internally, and this, you know, you can look at it from a figurative perspective, that your heart must be made pure if you want to experience the things that will give you the greatest success in life. I want to share to you news